Up the well we will shout, as the jerves and silks we rout. We've the spirit and the skill to set them reeling. Platted and buckled,
look at it!
All in it, green and blue, they'll remember Motherwell for many a day. Platted and buckled,
hey guys, Goggsy here, and welcome to a brand new series, which is Football Manager 2020, Mastering Motherwell. Now, I've tried my best to think outside the box for this series, because I don't want to just do a random, this is me taking this team to as high a level as I possibly can, and then it's just not being as creative as I possibly can be. So I'm trying to throw in some different ideas into the series throughout as I go on, basically. So here we go. We are here. I have got the Motherwell job. How I managed to get it? Well, it's very straightforward. Roll the clip.
Ah, Mr. Bonnes, in spite of the shaggy hairdo, looking very smart today.
Well, thing is, you never cheat on your barber.
With philosophies instilled like the Fir Park, I can only see a prosperous tenure under your management. You're hired.
Thank you very much.
So yeah, I've got the Motherwell job just because of a simple philosophy that I have instilled in my life. But yeah, now we're going to crack on, and hopefully you're going to enjoy the rest of the series, or what is the series of Mastering Motherwell. So I've mapped out what, in my opinion, is my best 11 at the moment. We've got, in goals, Mark Gillespie, Trevor Carson being injured, of course. I've got two wing-backs in Liam Grimshaw and Jake Carroll. The two centre-halves being Big Deck and Pete Hartley. Then I've got three in the midfield. We've got Liam Donnelly just sitting in between the back four and the two in the midfield as a ball-winning midfielder in the defensive mindset. Also with Alan Campbell being a defensive ball-winning midfielder. With Liam Polworth being the deep line playmaker, spraying those passes out wide and playing it over the top into Chris Long, who's up front, with the two wingers being Rolando Ahrens and Jermaine Hilton. Now, of course, we've got Rolando Ahrens for the whole season. Let's have a look at him quickly. I think he's worth like £6.5 million. Since when did Motherwell have a player of that value? In fact, he's only 23, it feels like he's been around forever. Now I've got to go and have a meeting with the club chairman about the club vision, see how we're going to do things for the next 5-year plan, should I say. should I last the whole 5 years at Motherwell? I mean, I'll be happy to last 5 weeks, to be honest, because I have no idea how I'm going to do with the added pressure of this being videoed for my YouTube channel. I've never done a career mode or a football manager save in my life for the benefit of the viewers because, well, for a starter, it's a huge commitment.
Develop players using the club's youth system. So a 5-year plan. Ongoing, maintain self-stability as a fan-owned club. Work within wage budget. Current season, top half. Scottish Cup quarter-final, Great Britain Cup third round.
What's the Great Britain Cup?
Some glorified caramel wafer cup that is basically every team in the UK participating.
Every team?
Every team. Betfred Cup quarter-final, would love a trip to Hampden.
Well, we're actually playing Queen's Park away at Hampden in the group stage of the Betfred Cup, so is that already ticked off the list then?
End of 2020 to 21 recognises as best of the rest. 21-22, continue qualifying for the Euro Cup onwards. I'll be here a close eye on your progress as manager and look forward to your end of the season appraisal. Welcome to Motherwell Football Club.
Thank you very much. It is a pleasure to be on board. Okay.
So here are our fixtures for the forthcoming season. We are starting off with a sort of training camp in Portugal. Then we've got Charleroi. I've actually been to Charleroi, the airport in Belgium. We were going to be playing another Belgian team called Zulte Waregem at home, but I decided to cancel it. I wanted a sort of glamour friendly because I wanted to generate some more income to try and, you know, get the club some more money. I mean, Tottenham over Zlatan Ibrahimovic any day, especially when it's just a friendly. Of course, in our Betfred Cup, we have got Clyde, Partick Thistle, Queen's Park and Stranraer. And then we've got Pontypridd away, a Welsh team, in the Great Britain Cup first round, which should be an interesting concept because I actually am for the idea of a sort of Great Britain Cup, but if it was a weekend game. But yeah, that'll surely clog up the fixture list if we get far in that. And August sees us play Livy at home, Ross County away, Celtic at home and Hearts away. If we get 7 points out of 12 there, I'll be more than delighted with that, considering we've got 3 very winnable fixtures in September. October's going to be a very difficult month, of course. We've got Aberdeen, Hibs, Rangers and St Mirren. Then Livy, Celtic, Ross County in November. Then December's going to be where shit hits the fan with Hearts, St Johnstone, Kilmarnock, Hamilton, Aberdeen, Hibs and Rangers. All in the space of a week there. Then first league game back after the winter break, we've got St Mirren, Livy, Ross County. Then February sees us take on Celtic, Hearts, Killy, St Johnstone. Then we roll into March with Hamilton, Aberdeen, Rangers, St Mirren and finish off with Hibs. Quick look at the squad. Of course, David Turnbull is out. Wanted by Arsenal and Tottenham. And he's, of course, out for up to 10 months. But, yeah, we've got Ross McKeever's wanted by a host of clubs on loan. And apart from that, there's not really much interest going about. I've also been doing some scouting. We'll be talking about that at a later date because I'm wanting to bring in a couple of players on loan to try and bolster the squad ahead of the forthcoming season, even though Rob was pretty much done all the job for me. Also, if you have any suggestions for a £5,000 transfer budget or a 1,100 wage budget on who to pick up for, say, a loan player, then please leave a comment because I could probably do with a bit of help. 1 eternity later. So now it is time for my first competitive match as Motherwell manager. As you'll see here, all these green dots of the pre-season, we won 4 out of the 5 games leading up to the Partick Thistle match, drawing 1 each with Portimonense after being 1-0 down after 20 minutes, and Mikkel and Jolie equalised. We beat Mafra 3-1, Donnelly penalty in 12 minutes, Tony Watt and Ross McKeever with the other goals. Beat Olyanense 3-0, Chris Long, Ahrens and Njoli with the goals, all the forwards getting in on the action. 1-4-0 away at Felgueras, Roland Ahrens hat-trick and Tony Watt scoring before a game on our home turf. Jermaine Hilton on 20 minutes, Liam Donnelly penalty 34. Yes, time to see if it will be Fir Hill for thrills, or will I have a very short honeymoon period? Let's get into it.
You stand here today, unveiled as the new Motherwell manager. As a big fan of the club, surely this must be a dream come true.
I've dreamt of this moment for years.
Many people think that Motherwell's wage budget is simply too small for you to bring in the high-quality players needed to improve the team. Are you going to approach your chairman and ask him to increase the wage budget?
I've got to work with what I have. I'm confident in the players we have left by my predecessor that we can have a solid season.
You've taken the step into football management being just 19 years of age. Critics have suggested that you will struggle to command respect in a dressing room that contains players that are much older than you are. What do you say to that?
I don't think age is important. I think the way you earn respect is by winning games. And with the quality we have in our squad, we've got no problem with that.
What was it about this job in particular that appealed to you?
Motherwell FC.
And does this squad have the necessary quality for you to achieve your targets?
One of the reasons why I was so keen to come here was because of the quality we had in our players.
Have you met the players yet? And if so, what is the mood in the camp?
They're excited for a fresh start and an opportunity to work under a new manager. Everyone's very upbeat.
And what role can the supporters play in moving this club forward?
The fans will play a massive part. They'll come in numbers, follow us around the country, and in all weather. And that's the most important thing.
And how far can you take this club?
Well, going by the M74, approximately 13.7 miles, because that's the distance between Fir Park and Hampden. So the team I'm rocking with is Gillespie in goal, Tate right back, Gallagher and Hartley, and then Carroll in left back, Liam Donnelly, centre defensive mid, Alan Campbell, Liam Polworth, Jermaine Hilton, Rolando Ahrens, and Christopher Long up front. Let's see what we can do. We can rest players if need be against Tottenham Hotspur in midweek, because it's only a friendly, it's just a cash grab. Before we get into the game though, I'm going to talk through my custom Goggsy press. We're going to play at defence, play through the middle, and we're just going to leave the underlap or overlap, because I mean we don't really have to specify, to be honest. We're just good in attack, I think. We're going to hit early crosses and make sure the players just shoot in sight, because I don't want to just Italian style walk the ball into the box. If we've got a chance to shoot, just go for it. That's my play style when I'm playing football, so that's it. And because I'm really confident about this game, I'm going to get the boys to run at the defence and be more expressive as well. Play at a high tempo. I don't want a time waste at all. I just want to get the business done and be 2 or 3 nothing up at half time and just see the game out. In transition, I want to counter press, make sure that the attack is the first line of defence, as cliche as it sounds. And then when possession has been won, I want to just counter, just hit them on the break. And I'm going to just select, I want to just distribute to the defence and just play from goalkeeper straight to the right back or centre half, whoever, I don't care. And just take short kicks, because this is the sort of game where you want to win comfortably. It's the first game of my tenure as Motherwell manager. Let's make it a good one. About to take charge in your first match as Motherwell manager. Can you sum up your feelings on an occasion like this? It's a special day. I can't wait to get started on this wonderful job. I think that's the best thing to say. Might you have a problem motivating the team against opposition like Partick Thistle? Complacency must surely be an issue ahead of this match. I'd say it's easy to switch off and simply assume we're going to win. I have to make sure the players are completely focused. Yeah. How important is it to start off your group fixtures with a victory? It's very, very important. Technically, it's the hardest game. On paper, it's the hardest game, so we have to go for it. And yeah, Richard Tate is my Swiss Army knife. Let's do this. Settings, we've got to change settings. Key highlights and camera 2D classic, because that's the only way to go for me. Right, go on, Hilton. Polworth at the post. Oh, it's on the line! No way! Oh, see, goal line technology. If goal line technology was a thing in Scottish football, I would love to see if I had actually crossed the line. Encouraged them after that. Liam Polworth almost scoring his first Motherwell goal. Yes, Alan Campbell, 1-0. That's what we like to see, boys. Oh, yes. Yes. First in the league, or first in the Cups League, anyway. That was a beautifully worked corner, straight from the training ground, if I don't say so myself. Half-time, 1-0 up, and team analysis. Jake Carroll won back possession more than any other player in his team. Richard Tate lost possession more than anyone. And a lot of dangerous attacks have involved Liam Polworth. I'm hardly surprised. Polworth is the catalyst in this team. Our both have 3-0 up against Inverness. What else do we see? Ah, my man Lewis scored at Montrose. 3-1 United. And battle. Dressing room, happy boys, happy lad. Things are going well. I'm happy with your performance so far. Yes, they're all ecstatic with that response. Hand over to Laz, see what he's got to say. The players look ready to walk through walls, such as the atmosphere in the team. Ah, you love to see it. You love to see it. Can't tell you what, that was the team karaoke session the night before. Right, 60 minutes. Tate's been booked. Surprise. We'll bring on Tony for Chris Long and Mikel and Julie for Jermaine. Carol and Julie! He's done more in 4 minutes than he's done in the whole time that he did playing for Motherwell. Brilliant. Great individual play by Carroll, and Mikael and Jolie heads home to make it 2-0. I could get used to this. Mikael and Jolie, the signing that never was in real life, has ended up being a great impact after 4 minutes being on the pitch. And that will be all, folks. Motherwell have won 2-0 in their first game of the Betfred Cup. A superb result. Man of the match goes to Liam Polworth for his stellar 9.0 rating. Looking very bright indeed after a comfortable win away. We only got one booking, which is alright. Check the dressing room. That's a give a passionate team talk. I'm very happy with the result and the way you played. Green's all over, boys. Even the subs are getting in the act and the positivity. It's just a massive, massive positive vibe right now in the Motherwell camp. And we'll just end it there. Don't need Keith to contribute anything. We're just gonna sit back, enjoy a cup of tea, analyse the performance. Stranraer scored again, so we are second right now, but that doesn't really matter. We won our toughest game quite handsomely, so I'm not that bothered. We're joint top. It's great. Liam Polworth, man of the match, of course. Ian McCall is the first manager to call me out for being a fraud, basically, saying that Motherwell aren't as good as they think. Oh, well, wouldn't you like to know? What was the score, Ian? Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like down below for more of this snazzy content. If we reach 50 likes on this video, we will have another episode up this week. It's up to you to make that happen, not up to me. Anyway, we'll see you in the next video. Take care. Da da da.
I should have had you right down there. That'd have been the perfect pan shot right there.